This mini split air conditioner circuit board is showing a communication fault. I have previously repaired it, but it still shows a communication problem. I have connected electric wires on the terminals of both the indoor and outdoor circuit boards. Now, I will test why this problem is shown. I will power on the circuit board. I have plugged the electric plug into the outlet. I will switch on the button now. The indoor circuit has been powered on. The temperature on the display is set to 30 degrees. It is set on heat mode. I have set the multimeter on DC voltages to test the circuit board. I will put the red probe on the 3-number terminal, which is the signal wire. The black probe on the neutral or 2-number terminal. Minus 4.87 volts, the multimeter is showing, which is not correct. I will change the side of the probes and then check the voltages. After changing the sides of the probes, the multimeter shows positive voltages, which means the plug I have attached has the wrong polarity inside the power socket. I will remove the plug and check it. The plug is attached in the correct polarity. I will test the number 1 terminal with the electric tester. The light is glowing on the line terminal, which means it is fine. Now I have disconnected the electricity supply from the circuit board. I will explain to you, the rest of the work I will do on DSO. The 1 and 2 number pins of the optocoupler are joined internally with the emitting diodes inside the IC. The signals that are generated will move to the opposite pins of the optocoupler. A transistor is on these opposite pins. The transistor turns on and the signals are further supplied to the rest of the circuit board. The second optocoupler is used to receive signals from the outdoor unit. The 1 and 2 pins on the optocoupler are the emitting diode, and the opposite pins are the transistor pins. In the same way, two optocouplers are installed on the outdoor circuit board. This optocoupler on the left, we can see its pin number 1. This means the emitting diode is installed here, which will receive the signals from the indoor unit. This optocoupler on the right is mounted in the reverse direction. It will send the outdoor signals towards the indoor circuit board. Between both the indoor and outdoor circuit boards, any one of them starts first. So, I will check which circuit board is the startup. First of all, I will check the indoor circuit board, and I have already set up the oscilloscope. I will check whether the signals from the optocoupler go out or not. I have power on the circuit board. The signals will pass through these pins where I have placed the probes. No signals are on these optocoupler pins. I will now check the signals on the receiving optocoupler pin numbers 1 and 2. No signals are on this optocoupler as well. This means the startup circuit board is the outdoor unit, and I will check whether the signals are coming out from its outdoor circuit board. Always remember this, whenever you are working on these circuit boards, some circuit boards make the signals out after a while, and sometimes they show the error code after half an hour. Both those circuit boards show the error code quickly, which means those circuit boards complete the function rapidly. To check those circuit boards, the person will have to be more efficient in testing whether the signals are passing or not. I will turn on the circuit board now. I will have to test it quickly, as the circuit board has turned on. It will make the signals out for a few seconds or a minute, and then it will stop them. I have attached the probes, my pupil is pressing the auto button on the oscilloscope. No signals are passing through these pins. Press the auto button again. No signals are passing through the optocoupler. I will now check the signals on this optocoupler. No signals on these pins of the optocoupler. I will check the signals on the other side of the optocoupler, as it is impossible that the signals are not passing from both the circuit's optocouplers. Now, to be more efficient in testing these signals, I will attach the probes before it is powered on. I will power on the circuit board. The circuit board has turned on. 1.2 volts are passing, but signals are not detected by the DSO. I will now clean these pins because the signal data is not captured by the DSO. That is why I am cleaning it. This is the ground pin, and this is the positive point coming from the capacitor. I have attached the probes of the DSO again before the circuit board is powered on. The circuit board has powered on. Press the auto button on DSO. The signals are now captured on the oscilloscope, which means the outdoor circuit is sending the signals to the indoor circuit board. But because there is a problem in the indoor circuit maybe, we saw that the outdoor circuit board generates signals and passes them toward the indoor circuit board, but the indoor circuit board can neither generate nor receive signals. I will turn off the circuit board once again. When the electric charge discharges completely from the outdoor and indoor circuit, and then I will turn it on. The light has stopped blinking. I will turn it on again. This optocoupler is the receiver of signals in the indoor circuit board. No signals are generated here, which means there is some kind of issue. As far as I'm thinking, there might be a problem with its wire, or the problem could be in the circuit after the optocoupler. I repaired this circuit board before, but it did not have this problem. It had a different issue before. I think something is disconnected in the circuit board, as I could not find it. So, I am trying my best to find it out. I will check the continuity of the wires. I have put the multimeter on continuity mode. I have placed one probe on the 3-number terminal and the other probe on this point to check the continuity of this wire. The continuity of this wire is absolutely fine. I will check the continuity of the signal wire on the outdoor circuit board as well. I have placed one probe on the 3-number terminal, the other probe with the wire inserted inside the circuit board. The wire on the outdoor circuit board is also okay. I will now test the physical parts of the circuit board. I am moving the parts so I can find any disconnection. Any resistor, capacitor, or other part could be faulty or disconnected. I have checked them already, and the circuit did not have this fault. Nothing is damaged or broken on this section of the circuit board. This means that the outdoor circuit is okay. Now, the checking turn is of the indoor circuit board. This capacitor is fine. The rest of the parts are also fine. This resistor is installed here, a capacitor. And see this, a sensor is mounted on this circuit board. It is a PTC sensor. One leg of the PTC sensor has broken. This problem occurs most of the time while the circuit board is being fitted. A part can break while the circuit board is in your hand when any component is tilted accidentally. As what happened in this circuit board, I will desolder the PTC and solder it back to the circuit board. I have removed it from the circuit board. Now, I will clean the excess soldering from the holes. I will insert it back into the circuit board. I will solder it, but before that, I will tilt its pin slightly. This is to prevent the PTC from going out of the circuit board. I have started the circuit board again. It works the same at 30 degrees. The outdoor light is also blinking. I have placed the probes on the 2- and 3-number terminals to check their voltages. The voltage is fluctuating now, meaning the circuit board will work now. The circuit board has started the compressor. All the lights are working on the analyzer. This means the circuit board has been fixed. I am tired now, and I run on coffee. So buy it for me on Patreon. Click the link on the screen to visit. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.